Alright, hey guys, welcome back to another video, and today I'm just going to be showing you a glow masking effect and how you can kind of like outline an enemy player with it. And it's a pretty cool effect, so yeah, to stay tuned, and if you guys could help me hit my 1k sub goal, that would be really great, and I'm trying to hit it by the beginning of next year. So yeah, please, I'll be doing daily uploads, and please try to help me hit that goal. So without further ado, let's start. So let's find the kill first. The gunshot is here, so let's mark that. So and then I usually like going 3 frames ahead, so just here, and then I'll cut and I add 60 onto this, so 283. And yeah, so there we have our clip, and then we just want to nest this once we're done. Okay, but this is a build up tutorial, so let's say around here ish so when I reset the ramp, I'm going to cut this here, and I'm going to start masking. So what you want to do is go to your opacity here, and you see this kind of like polygon thing, round thing. So we're just gonna drag it and increase the feather up to like 200, and then what we want to do is you want to move these two up. Sorry if you can hear my dog barking. Alright, so now we're gonna clear it, and you might not be able to see the mask anymore, but that's perfectly fine, because over here we're gonna actually do like a opacity dip. So let's keyframe this here, and like keyframe the end at like 30, and what you kind of want to do is make sure your mask path, you need to make sure you keyframe this, and then make sure it's constantly on the enemy. So all right, keep going. Swings over a bit more here, and honestly, I think you can actually change it so that it starts off at 30, and you kind of make it dip before. So around here, you would go here, and then I would keep it 100. And just make it 30 or so. I don't think that looks too great, so maybe we do 40. Personally, I don't think that's too nice. Yeah, I think we need to stick to the original. Except we can make it start 100 and hit 30s sooner. Maybe slightly higher, like 50. Alright, and now what you want to do is probably go to like a glow. I personally think S_glow is fine. So you can actually play around with this quite a lot, so we can try this. It's really up to you, I mean, because there's a lot of different glows. I mean, typically I would just use this, and I would change it. And then I would increase the brightness a little, glow width maybe. It's actually fine. Only problem is a lot of the characters blocked in this clip, so it's not the greatest example in my opinion. Alright, so I don't know if this isn't too great of an example, but personally I wouldn't really use it here, but if you really wanted to, I would also add a bit of shake onto it. So let's put S underscore S nest fat first. Alright. Now go to S underscore shake. And I just make sure everything except for my, so everything is zero except for my Y. My Y kind of want it at 2. Okay, now alright, so keyframe the frequency around 32. This is gonna be 0. I'm gonna slowly increase it to 1. So alright, so you want to make sure this is 200. And now since it's sounding a little boring, I'm just going to add a random song. Okay, now what you want to do is probably add a slow-mo. So I always add slow-mo on the impact of it. And then what you want to do, I think I'm going to show you guys how to do a screen pump. So it's going to be S blur mo curve. Now you, so pretty much. Alright, so what you want to do now is you want to make sure this is starting at 1. Keyframe this, and then right here, you want to set it to 0.8 or 0.9, whatever you want. And then you want to set that back out to 1. Alright, now let's just... Now you can also make it slightly less, you can make it like 0.9, but and I think that looks good so far. Alright, so let's go to Flickr. And then you want to just kind of keyframe this at, I would say 0.3. And then here you want to set it back to 0, but I would keyframe it another 0.3 over here. Alright, now let's just auto-bezier that as well. I think that looks good, so that's pretty much how you kind of do the pre-glow. Now you could have a slightly stronger pre-glow, So let's say you want like something that's strong enough, you could kind of bump that up to 8 or something. And you can actually kind of decrease the glow width. So I'd kind of up it to a point where it's kind of smooth, but also. And kind of bump up the X width as well, so it's slightly fatter to the side. I think 2 or 3 is fine. And I think that's about it. So that's gonna be it for this tutorial, and I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you guys in the next one.